classified as a force of nature now, baby. There's tornado watches outside. There's a nitro watch inside. We're hot and we're ready to go, Weasel.
And what I'm interested in is if Hulk Hogan will choke like the shark Greg Norman did at the Masters. Can he do this by himself?
Oh, wait a minute. Hulk Hogan hits the ring. Arn Anderson and the Taskmaster immediately glove him. This a handicap match. This originally scheduled to be a return match with Hulk Hogan and the Booty Man to take on Anderson and Taskmaster. But the Booty Man hurt 2 weeks ago on WCW Saturday Night. Hogan so incensed, he said, I'll take you both on. But Heenan, there's some stipulations that you've been laughing about all day.
Well, they're very simple. If Hogan wins this match, he gets a manager in the ring. He can have Miss Elizabeth, he can have Lauren.
Look at that, a figure four right off the bat.
But he don't have it locked on good.
He's turning the horse. Oh!
And don't forget, if the Taskmaster and Arn Anderson win this one, they get 5 minutes with guess who? Kimberly the Booty Babe.
Now wait a minute, let's get it straight. Hogan wins, he gets 5 minutes alone with the manager or managers of his choice. Anderson, Taskmaster win. They get to pick up where Liz and Woman left off with the Booty Babe.
That's right, and Diamond Dallas Page, they say, is on the streets. He's broke, he's poor. She's gonna be on the streets broke and poor. She may be in a body cast.
This one is gonna be interesting.
Well, look at what's happening out here. I was afraid of this. Hulk Hogan painted himself in a corner with this match. These two hurt the Booty Man, so he said, I'll take you on by myself. But if you remember, Bischoff, Hogan lost to Arn Anderson on a Monday Nitro, and now he's taking on Arn Anderson and the Taskmaster. I don't know what's going to happen in this one.
Well, I'll tell you what, Hulk Hogan is inspired. This is a Hulk Hogan that we have seen in the past. This is a Hulk Hogan who has dominated all of the action inside of the ring, outside of the ring, and anywhere else he goes. And that's the one thing about Hogan. You get him teed off, and he gets madder and madder. I mean, he hulks up, it can be over for anybody.
Well, that's because of the humanoid Hulkamaniacs out there. They get his blood pumping. They give him the adrenaline to keep moving like this. If they'd shut up, we'd get rid of this joker.
Hulk Hogan in control. This is the Hulk Hogan I like to see. This is the Hulk Hogan that would know. Oh. Hogan. Hogan now digging maybe a little too deep. Reaching for a chair. He's cleaning house.
Well, I'd like to tell you one thing. If he cleans these two clocks, I don't see why that man shouldn't be wearing that championship belt around his waist before long.
Never mind what you're worried about. They got tornado warnings outside, and there's a hurricane going on right here in the building right now. I don't know who's the legal man in this ring. I don't know if there is a legal man in this ring.
I want to know one thing. What is Liz thinking about? What is Woman thinking about? If they have to face Hulk Hogan when this thing's over. But on the flip side, what about the Booty Babe?
Well, she's worried. She has plenty worried. Because he's out there all by himself at the hands of Arn Anderson, Jimmy Hart, the Taskmaster. He's not going to make it.
Look at him. Jimmy Hart out there with the megaphone, kicking away, taking cheap shots wherever he can. Arn Anderson, choking.
Well, you gentlemen forget if Hogan got himself in this predicament. He's the one that said, I'll take two men out. He's unbeatable. He can do whatever he wants.
Well, he's taking three on right now. You saw the mouth of the South in there, and that's my odds-on favorite who Hogan wants. If you remember, my friend, he's the one that turned on Hogan in the first place.
A lot of action coming up here on WCW Monday Night Show, including Public Enemy and the Nasty Boys. I have heard back in the locker room area, both teams screaming at each other. This one is going to be exciting, to say the least. Two of the most unpredictable teams. I hope they've got the furniture tied down.
And Savage is loose. He's in the building.
So is Ric Flair. Ric Flair, after everything he's done on television, said about the Macho Man Randy. Oh, look at this.
Well, they got the tables turned on them there. They were trying to put the Booty Man pile driver on Hogan, and he turned the tables on him, baby.
The Macho Man Randy Savage will be taking on Earl Robert of Eaton, but you got to wonder about the Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Oh!
Hey, oh, man!
Oh, no!
Come